Hello friends, I am Dr. Vishwajit Sampatrao Ghorpade, working as Assistant Professor in Pharmaceutics Department at School of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Sanjay Ghodavat University, Kolhapur. Today we are going to talk on Kahoot, a game-based student response system which can be used to make the teaching-learning process more interactive. After completion of this video, you will be able to understand the steps which are involved in creating account and quizzes in Kahoot. You will be able to create your own account in Kahoot, and also you will be able to create the quizzes in Kahoot. Now let us see what is this Kahoot. Kahoot is a student response system which can be used to create quiz, facilitate discussions, collect survey data or conduct polls on the web-based platform. It creates a game-like atmosphere due to which the student engagement is enhanced and the classes become more interactive. Let us see what are the basic requirements to play Kahoot. For teacher and the students, computer or laptop are essential if you want to play the Kahoot. Besides, there should be presence of LCD projector, LCD screen, and internet with a speed of 3 Mbps. Therefore, we can say that the ideal place to play Kahoot would be the computer lab. But if the teacher wants to conduct the Kahoot quiz in a classroom where computers and laptops are not available for the students, then the teachers can permit the use of tablets and smartphone by the students in their classroom. Now the question is how to create and play Kahoot. If the teacher wants to create a Kahoot account or a Kahoot quiz, the teachers must visit the website www.getkahoot.com. Now, once the Kahoot quiz is created and the students want to play that Kahoot quiz, in that case, students must visit www.kahoot.it. If the students are using smartphones to play the Kahoot quiz, they can also download a Kahoot app from the Play Store. Now, let us go to the Kahoot website and let us see how to create the Kahoot account and the Kahoot quiz. So, in the address bar of this Google Chrome web browser, we are going to type getkahoot.com and press enter. Once we press enter, we reach the home page of kahoot.com. Now, towards left hand side, you can see a green button on which it is written sign up for free. We are going to click on this button. Once we click on that button, the Kahoot will ask us that how do we want to use this Kahoot? Do we want to use it as a teacher, as a student, socially or at work? We are going to use it as a teacher, so click on the first orange tab. Now, Kahoot will give us three options: whether we want to sign up using our Google account, whether we want to sign up using our Microsoft account, or whether we want to sign up using our other email ID such as institutional email ID. In this case, I am going to click on the first tab, that is sign up using the Google account. So a new pop-up window appears where I am going to select my first Google account. Now Kahoot will ask us our account details. So in the first test box, we are going to add the name of our school or university or the college. In order to enter the workplace details, you are going to click on this black button so that you will get a drop-down menu. Select higher education in this drop-down menu. And lastly, you are going to pick up your username. In my case, I will select Vish Ghorpade as a username. Now you will see that after selecting my username, the text box border has become blue. This means Kahoot has accepted my username. But if there are some other players who already have taken this username, in that case, the border of this text box will appear red. This means Kahoot is not accepting that username and you have to change that username. Now below, you are going to put a check mark on this small box, which indicates that you have read the terms and conditions of Kahoot and you agree with it. There is no need to check the other two boxes. So I will uncheck the second box and I'm going to click on Join Kahoot. Now Kahoot asks us to choose our plan. In case of Kahoot, there are four plans. The first plan is the basic plan, which is a free plan. Plus plan, pro plan, and premium plan are the other three plans which are paid plans. But still you can enjoy free trial of these three plans for 7 days. Now below you can see the features of all the four plans. The basic plan, which is a free plan, in that case only 50 players or 50 students can participate in a Kahoot quiz. In case of plus plan, 100 students can participate. In pro, 200, and in case of premium, 2000 students can participate in your Kahoot quiz. Besides, in basic plan, the type of questions which you can ask is limited. Means you can only ask multiple choice type of questions or true or false type of questions. But in pro and premium, you can also ask surveys, or you can conduct polls, you can ask puzzles, etc. Now below the basic plan, you will find one button that is continue for free. You are going to click on this button. So now Kahoot welcomes us and asks us to enter our name. So let me enter my name. So I have entered my name and I will click on done. So here we are on the user dashboard. Now in this user dashboard, in middle, you will see one button that is create Kahoot. So you are going to click on this button to create your Kahoot quiz. Now a new pop-up window appears where again you are going to click on this green colored create button under new Kahoot. Now on this page, you can start adding your questions for your quiz. But before that, you have to give a proper title to your quiz, and for that, you have to click on this text box present at the top of this page where it is written enter Kahoot title. So I will click on this text box. A new pop-up window appears where I am going to enter the title of my quiz. Let us say pharmaceutics. If you want to give description of your quiz over here, you can give the description. Below, I am not going to make any change at any other place given over here because it is essential for me. Now, if you want to make certain changes, such as if you want to change the cover image of your Kahoot quiz, or if you want to change the lobby music, means the music which constantly plays when your question is displayed in front of students, you can make those changes over here. Also, you can change the cover image by clicking on this button change. When you click on change button, you can either upload the image which is already present on your computer, or you can select the image from the library of the Kahoot. Currently, I'm not going to make any change in my cover image. So let us directly click on done, which is the button present at the bottom of this pop-up window. So now you will see that my quiz has got a title, that is pharmaceutics. And now I can start adding my questions. So here it is written, click to start typing your questions. Here you can type your question. Let me say my question is product of ampicillin is. So I have added my question. Below you will see towards left hand side, there is a circular button on which it is written 20 seconds. This is the time limit which is given to the students to answer the specific question during the quiz. Now, if you want to change the time limit within which the student should give the answer to your question, you are going to click on this button and you are going to select the time limit according to the difficulty of your question. If your question is more difficult, you can give more time limit for the students to answer that question. The lowest time limit is 5 seconds and the highest time limit is 240 seconds. In my case, I will keep it 20 seconds only. Below, you can also change the points which the students will score on giving right answer to your question. Currently, they are going to score 1000 points for the right answer. But you can also change it by clicking and dragging this button towards the right hand side so that the points will become 2000, or you can also minimize it. But currently I am going to keep it 1000 only. Now you can add your options over here. So once you add all the four options, you will see that the push buttons on which you have written the options have got certain color. Also, each push button is having certain shape towards left hand side. These shapes and these colors are to differentiate your options when your question is displayed in front of the screen of the students. For example, if your students are playing this quiz on their mobile phone, they will not observe the names of the options. For example, they will not observe naloxone, pyrampicillin, cloxacillin and chloramphenicol permitted, but they will only observe the push buttons, which are red, blue, yellow and green in color, along with these shapes. However, they can see the options on the bigger screen, which is displayed by the teacher. Now, whichever is the correct option, you are going to click on the circle present in front of that option. For example, for this question, the correct answer is pyrampicillin. So I will click on the circle in front of pyrampicillin. When I click it, see the circle turns green and a check mark appears on that circle. Here, you can also add certain questions where you want the students to identify certain image or logo. For example, if you want the students to identify certain chemical structure, in such type of questions, you can directly drag and drop the image from your computer over here in this dotted box. Also, you can upload that image by clicking on this upload image button, or you can import the image which is already present in the library of Kahoot by clicking on this first button, that is image library. Besides, if you want to show certain YouTube video to the students and you want the students to identify the things related to that video, then you can click on this third button on which it is written YouTube link. Now, if you want to add another question, towards the left hand side, you can see a button on which it is written add question. You are going to click on this button and you will see that various options are provided to you. So what type of question do you want to add next? Whether you want to add a quiz where multiple choice type of question can be added, which we did just now, whether you want to add a true or false type of question. The other options are there, for example, open-ended, puzzle, word cloud, poll, slide, but these are available only in case of upgraded version, that is the paid versions. So for basic version, you can only ask these two types of question, that is the quiz or the true or false. So let us add true or false type of question. Now the correct answer for this question is true. So I will click on true. Now, once you have added all your questions, you can directly click on this green button, that is done button, which is present towards the right hand upper corner of this web page. And a new pop-up window will appear, which says that now our Kahoot is ready to be played. You are going to click on this done button. And now you will see that your Kahoot has been created. The title of your Kahoot is Pharmaceutics. There are two questions in your quiz. So here you will see that two Qs is written. So in this video, we have learned how to create a Kahoot account and a Kahoot quiz. In next video, we will see how to implement the Kahoot quiz in your classroom. Thank you for watching this video and happy learning.